every society needs an ecological space where they can just go, relax and relieve all their stress and tension. With this in mind, the idea of Manipal Lake was born. This place was made for proper rainwater harvesting and to provide a communal space where everyone can relax and enjoy the beauty of nature. Over the years, it has restored the ecological balance of Manipal, which has resulted in it becoming home to various flora and fauna. People's health and wellness have also improved due to the increase in physical activities like jogging and other sports activities. This idea is great, and Manipalites are proud to have such a place in their surroundings. Manipal Lake, cry of peril. Before 2003, Manipal had 100 acres of land which was full of acacia trees. This wasn't creating any problem for anyone, but a lot of useful land was being wasted. It was also the only place where abundance of soil was there, which in rainy season became a sort of lake due to waterlogging. Hence, it was known by the name Manapala. Mana means soil in Kannada and Pala means lake.
Manipal Lake was a place where the water from the catchment area used to come, deposit the soil and used to flow out. And after the rainy season, it used to be almost barren. And I remember in the earlier days, even MIT used to conduct their sports day in the Manapala. That was the initial stages of Manapala, and it continued till the developmental activities was undertaken.
It was the MLA UR Sabapati along with Mr. Bogiraj, a retired army officer, who ideated the formation of this area into a lake. Their intentions were simple: to provide a proper rainwater harvesting system, which will in turn improve the underground water table.
People in and around Manapala must be thankful to Manapala for the water. If you see the entire area around in and around Manapala, all the people who have got borewell, they have got sufficient water. All borewells with the, you call flats and all, fully charged with water, and they have, even in, during the peak summer, they are not having any water problem, which was earlier 5 to 10 years, it was a severe problem. They used to get water by tankers.
This would also weed out the waterlogging happening in the rainy season and also provide a large area for people to live. Over the years, this area was further developed by the district commissioners of Manipal. Mr. Ponu Raj was one such DC. He took 50 lakhs funds from the government and built restaurants around lake to get revenue for maintenance. After Mr. Ponu Raj, Mrs. Hemlata came. She organized a Zilla Utsav whose sole purpose was to collect funds for further development and maintenance of the lake. One of the major developments in her tenure was the removal of slums near the lake area. Once Mrs. Hemlata's tenure was over, Dr. Reju became the DC. Proper cementation of jogging tracks, activation of bore wells to provide water for household purposes. The area, however, still lacked some things. It was then the DC Vishal who took 1.3 crores from Udupi Urban Development Authority and demarcated the lake area to prevent illegal encroachment. He also installed dustbins and solar street lights. As long as we're looking at the developments made, the contributions of Rotary Manipal cannot be neglected. They made a children's park, an auditorium, and a library near the lake area to increase its value. Alongside that, they also developed a proper entrance for the lake. Since the area to maintain is large, it becomes difficult for the DC. In order to do so properly, it was decided to release a tender for the maintenance of the lake. At 2.25 lakhs, Mr. Nagraj Reddy got the tender for the maintenance. He may have maintained it initially, but in recent times, there is not much to see.
With a separate transformer, so that water is available continuously 24/7 for developmental activities. Today, Udupi gets water once in 2 days, but these plants can get water 24/7, but unfortunately there is no one to water the plants. It is all done by the public here, who have got some interest. They do come. Most of them are senior citizens and some ladies. They come and water the plant once in a while, just to see that plants don't die. There is no question of, there is no activity of development as such.
There is no proper cleaning of the lake, no maintenance of pipelines whatsoever, and he also put fees to enter the lake so that the money collected can be utilized for maintenance. He can dupe us by saying this, but we all know the reality. Mr. Bhojraj, the real man behind the whole plan, knew from the starting that privatization of management will definitely lead to the exploitation of this beloved lake. He had also spent most of his time working for the lake with full dedication.
He's just like, you know, he's been dreaming about the, like, just it was water coming and flowing off, getting dry, and all, everything was dry. There was no tree, only that, the other trees.
No,
acacia trees and the Parthenium grass all around. Only those things were there. So we used to regularly, you know, go and cut by getting up by 5:30 to still 7:30 regularly. So think that his man has gone out of his mind, you know. But then it was not so. Slowly the development started happening. He started meeting GDCs, meeting the politicians, people around. So then it's, we could see the thing coming up, getting the things planted. Acacia was slowly cut, and the forest top people were little interested in him. Yes, this man means some business. So they also started, you know, getting inside.
Many district commissioners came, and all of them made significant developments to the lake. Since the privatization of the management staff, the maintenance standards have definitely gone down. But even after all this, we should all hope the best for Manipal Lake.